We are going to talk about landmarks. What are landmarks? Well, originally, when we would talk about landmarks, it meant a prominent, easily identified geographic point that was used by explorers to navigate. So this would be like a mountain, a cliff, or a river, something naturally occurring. But now, in modern day, we also use the word landmark to include it for places that tourists go to that are beautiful or big, and or have some sort of historical importance. So overall, these are important places, often beautiful, often big, often have historical importance of some sort, might be easily identified from pictures or from far away. And the two categories of landmarks, which you probably have guessed at this point, are natural and man-made. So natural ones, like I said before, are like mountains, rivers, cliffs. These are things that are just formed through time over nature, and man-made structures are ones that have been designed and built by humans. So we are going to be talking about 10 different landmarks around the world, 5 natural and 5 man-made. They are Mount Kilimanjaro, Grand Canyon, the Amazon rainforest, Mount Fuji, Victoria Falls, the great temples of Abu Simbel, Taj Mahal, the Eiffel Tower, Mount Rushmore, and the Sydney Opera House. Let's start with Mount Kilimanjaro in Kilimanjaro, Tanzania. Now, Mount Kilimanjaro, which means shining mountain in Swahili, which is one of the main languages that they speak in Tanzania, is the tallest freestanding mountain rise in the world. It stands at around 15,000 feet from its base, which is about 2,830 of me. So if you can imagine 2,830 of me's stacked up on top, then you would get the height of Mount Kilimanjaro. As you grow higher, or as you walk up to the top of Mount Kilimanjaro, and as you get higher from the base or further away from the base, it gets colder and colder. In fact, at one point, most of it was covered in snow and ice. And when you're walking, you can actually feel the temperature difference. It does have explosive eruptions, though the last major one was over 100,000 years ago, and it is a stratovolcano. It actually takes from anywhere from a week to 2 weeks to climb it, but people do it regularly. Next, let's talk about the Grand Canyon in Arizona of the United States. So the Grand Canyon is about 277 miles long, 18 miles wide, and over a mile deep at some of its deepest part. Evidence suggests that it established its course, the Grand Canyon River, at least 17 million years ago, and over time it eroded and came into what we think of now as the Grand Canyon. It is a huge canyon of rock structures of different colors. People come from all over to hike the Grand Canyon. They can take trips on rafts or boats floating down the river and can even go camping. The Amazon rainforest. Now, the Amazon rainforest is actually in over a couple different parts of South America. 60% of it is in Brazil, but it's also in Peru and many other countries. It is the largest forest that grows in the tropical basin of the Amazon River. It represents over half of the planet's remaining rainforest, and it was formed at least 55 million years ago. The rainforest, the Amazon rainforest, is incredibly rich in biodiversity. That means it has so many plants and animals. It has around 2.5 million insect species, tens of thousands of plant species, around 2,000 species of birds and mammals, and around 2,000 species of fish as well. Mount Fuji. Now, Mount Fuji is the tallest mountain in Japan. It is a famous cultural icon in their art, often used in paintings and in photography. It is officially classified as an active volcano, though the last eruption began in December of 1707 and ended on January 1st of 1708. It is a very sacred mountain and actually named after a Buddhist fire goddess, and definitely a place of worship. Many climb it, and at the very top of Mount Fuji is a post office, which is only open during the summer. The last natural landmark we're going to talk about is Victoria Falls. And Victoria Falls is in the Zambezi River between Zambia and Zimbabwe. It was discovered by David Livingstone in November 1855, and he named it after Queen Victoria, Victoria Falls. It is one of the world's largest waterfalls, and near the edge, there is a naturally formed armchair, which many people try to swim in. There is lots of animal and plant life. Let's move on to the man-made landmarks in the world. So the great temples of Abu Simbel are twin temple complexes originally cut from solid rock cliff. They are created around 1244 BCE, though when they were actually created is up to interpretation of historians, but it was during the reign of Ramses II and definitely took 20 years for them to be created. Eventually, in 1968, however, the temples were completely relocated, not too far away, but to avoid the submersion of the Lake Nassar, which has been known to flood. The Taj Mahal in India was a tomb built in the 17th century by the Mughal King Shah Jahan in memory of his wife. His remains were also put into the tomb. It is located in the city of Agra in Uttar Pradesh. It is an ivory-white marble mausoleum in the center of a 42-acre complex. It is super big. Also on the complex is a mosque, a guest house, and large formal gardens. The Eiffel Tower. The Eiffel Tower was built in 1887 through to 1889 for the Exposition Universelle and is located in Paris, France. It is about 324 meters high. It has 1,665 steps and weighs 10,000 tons. It uses 20,000 sparkling lights to cover the entire Eiffel Tower. It was built by Gustave Eiffel in memory of the French Revolution, and millions of people have visited. A man-made landmark in the United States is Mount Rushmore in South Dakota. It is a granite sculpture carved into rock. Mount Rushmore includes 60-foot sculptures of four presidents. Construction began in 1927, and was completed around 1941 and was designed by Goodson Borglum. The four presidents are George Washington, Thomas Jefferson, Theodore Roosevelt, and Abraham Lincoln. These presidents were specifically chosen to respectively represent the nation's birth, George Washington, the nation's growth, Thomas Jefferson, the nation's development, Theodore Roosevelt, and the nation's preservation, Abraham Lincoln. And finally, the last landmark we are going to talk about is the Sydney Opera House in Sydney, Australia. This opera house is located on the shores of the Sydney Harbour. It is shaped like sails of a boat, began construction in 1959, opened in 1973, and was finished a decade, 10 years later. It is a multi-venue performing arts center and has lots of notable performances. These are just some of the many, many, many landmarks located in the world. Like I said, both natural and man-made. Please think of some of the ones that you know about. What have you seen pictures of? What have you read about in books? What have you seen on TV? Here is a short quiz. Thank you for watching.